Get it, air. Testing 1, 2, 3. No, thank you. Can you hear me? Give me some loud music tonight. We'll just see what we can do. So I have a photograph of the bride and groom. I do have a grid on it. I may or may not put a grid on the canvas. That remains to be seen. But one thing is for sure I've learned, you can't, at least for me, you cannot start with a grid because you don't know where to put it, how big to make it, or anything. So you have to paint, first of all, just a believable shape of the bride and groom. A grid might come later. By the way, if you want a very small tip about doing portraits, hello?
Hello, I was just watching.
Thank you. It helps, actually having a grid on the photograph helps even if you don't do a grid on the canvas. Do you? Cool. Me too. Thank you. Okay. I did what I almost always do. First of all, I made the groom a little too narrow. See, I'd rather start out too narrow than too fat. If I start out too fat, I really, really never recover. But as is often the case, yeah, but I made them a little bit too elongated. They are a handsome couple. I say that without any equivocation or hesitation. So that does make my job a little bit easier, and he's taller than her. I shouldn't be saying that, should I? Because there might be some future clients watching. Glad to do, don't worry, I'm delighted to do portraits of brides who are taller than me. I'm probably being sexist at some horrible thing. Now, the next thing I need to do is literally step back 15 or 20 feet from this painting and look at it from a distance and see if I like that side. Believe it or not, I think I can actually make them slightly larger, which is sort of a good problem to have. I'd rather have to go larger than smaller. Good, unless that came off, I don't think it would, so that's nice. Okay, so slightly larger. I'm going to leave top of the head showing. So that's something to compare. All right, that's just a little bit better. So now I'm thinking,
moment. Time, we want to introduce our bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Chris Thomas Edo.
I'm going to assume you can hear me, but I no longer have an in-ear monitor. I have an in-ear.
Be a friend, and I know that I will be a
Yes, I'm on my way. I'm not going to stay. Brushes, by the way, do you see the angle that I'm holding? I use this trick a lot when I am doing architecture, right? I do the, you know, the pitch of the roof and so forth. I'm doing exactly the same thing right now. But I'm doing it for
you.
Sent here in heaven, this is daddy's little girl. As I drop, she talks to Jesus, and I close my eyes, and I thank God for all the joy in my life. Oh, what a nice time. From butterfly kisses to bedtime prayer. I'm gonna get to the middle of discern that it's not the original. First playing this music.
And though the cake looks wrong, but I sure tried. Oh, with all that I've done wrong, I must have done something wrong to deserve a song every morning. Kisses at night. Ooh, like the wind is blowing.
Thank you. blocked him.
But anyway, we want to thank all of you for coming.
Well, he's wearing a blue-black suit. I'm not trying to go double-check. Is it pure black or blue?
First of all, the dances were great.
But I don't trust the photo.
Remember, Howard and I clearing the dance floor without you. Okay. Butch, where are you? Right there. It's Lindsay's first boyfriend. About 18 months old, Howard would come home from work and say, "Who's your boyfriend, Lindsay?" And she'd say, "Butch. Butch." So you lost out, Butch. Just didn't wait long enough. And there are people that are not here that we definitely wish were here. Of course, that's from your dad. And also, we want to remember Buster Motley, who's going through a health crisis, and wish that they could be with us. And George Perry, who has been a father to these children for the last 9 years. And we miss him terribly, and he is so sorry he couldn't.
George!
Yeah. So please keep George in your prayers. Think about him, and that's all. I guess thanks for being here, and Russ is going to say a few words. I promised her I wouldn't embarrass her, but I did take the checkbook today. Yours.
This journey, being grateful for your friends, your family, and what they can, what you can mean for them, and what they can do for you. But I spent some time with Chris, and I think you all know Lindsay, and know Chris now. Said they are perfect because as outgoing as Lindsay is, Chris is a common influence. If it's true that opposites attract, so to speak. They've hit a home run here. But we're thankful to be here. We certainly remember the ones that can't be with us. Let's raise our glasses, and I leave you with this. May all your days be happy ones, great health, and all good blessings. Cheers.
Cheers.
And at this time, we're going to have our blessing. Once again, I want to express my appreciation to Chris and Lindsay for the chance to come and be here with you all at this special event. Before I say the blessing, as I stand here with the champagne getting ready to toast, I feel much like the Methodist minister that got pulled over by a state trooper. And I said, "Have you been drinking?" And he said, "No, sir, I've been drinking water." He says, "Well, you smell like wine." He goes, "Daggone, he did it again." I'm sorry. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, your first miracle was performed at the wedding. And we thank you so much for your presence here. And we thank you for the miracle of love, which exists and will remain with Chris and Lindsay. Bless them, Lord, and bless us as we come together. Be especially with those we've mentioned today. Put your healing hand upon them and let us feel the presence of those that are in at the heavenly banquet today. Bless the food we're about to receive. In Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, your stations are now open.
So, I don't know if you can hear me. A little while ago I was saying there's two parts of the female anatomy in particular you want to exaggerate just a little bit. One is slight elongation of the neck. If you overdo it, you know, you get caught. It's like, I don't want to get caught. I don't want people to say, ooh, you made your neck long. No, that would be, I just want to do it enough so that another way to put it is I want to make sure I don't shortchange her neck at all. If anything, air a little bit on the side of lengthening. And the other bit of anatomy is just a tiny little tuck at the waist. And again, I'm saying this, especially today, about a bride who's just as lovely as she can be. She doesn't need, so to speak, any help. But right under her elbow, right here, right there. In fact, probably we'll bring that in about an eighth of an inch. Just let me make a mark there. Probably about like that. Which is a slight exaggeration. No, I've got problems. I just see. She's coming up a little too far from him. So, and here's where sometimes the grid lines can help me a little bit, because I want to look at the front of his coat. Comes out, ooh, yeah, okay, good, that helps a lot. The furthermost point of his suit coat essentially lines up with the edge of her face. So I'm there. Again, maybe a little too narrow. Now maybe that his head's in there, but that's always possible too. So what was making her look too wide was actually the result of him being a little bit too. Anybody so much. It doesn't mean much. It looks like she's got black teeth. And even though I'm not at all sure that that lines up, I'm going to and that's likely to be all of that stuff in here. Hello?
Lindsay's my little sister.
Oh, I see. But she's beautiful. You didn't beat her up too bad.
No. She looks like she did in high school. This is great.
Thank you. I'm Dan. What's your name?
Hudson.
Hi, Hudson. Good
Hudson
to meet you.
Hudson Dunn. Nice.
Where do you live?
Here in Danville.
Okay, so this is like the family home, right?
Oh, yeah. This is where we all grew up.
Fantastic.
Where are you from?
Raleigh. Well, 30 years Raleigh.
I might be relocating there in a couple months.
Really? I understand. They moved there, right?
From Nashville.
Yeah.
But, wow.
Well, I got a long ways to go. I'll be painting till midnight. So,
really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Right now.
Thank you.
Awesome job.
Thank you. Okay, now I'm gonna move his.
Thank you. Right
now. Are we a part? Are we participating in this?
Goodbye, watching. You mean do you get to paint?
Yes. We get to paint.
No.
Okay.
good question. No. What, you'll see when I'm finished. It'll be good.
I'll be in this picture.
Yes, that's right.
I'll
get you in there. You're one of these blue people. With there you go. That might be you right there.
That's awesome.
Thank you. Okay, there we go. That's a little better. Move his face forward. Got her head cocked back, a real cute angle. Okay, good babies. Now I've got them too skinny on the back. So, I mean, they're too wide on the back. So I need to pop them a little bit. Try to get a real quick possible. Yeah, I don't want either of them heavier and slenderized people just a little bit, just enough so that hopefully they don't get caught. Before I get bogged down, I'm going to look at this. Thank you.
You're like, woo!
It's good. I need to stand back and look at about 15, 20 feet and look at this again and make sure that I'm happy with their size and placement. Now's the time to change. What time is it? 7:30. I have only 4.5 hours to change this team. I will use every bit of that. So funny, people like that lady that around there thought maybe this was a group participation painting. Kind of tells you what she thinks about my style. That's funny. It's so messy, she thought everybody was doing it. That's a person. That's funny. I'm not laughing at her. I'm just laughing at her. All right, pardon me for a minute and step away. Look at this from the distance. Bottom of the back of the dress and down. Yeah, I think that's about as big as I dare make them. like her Jenny Lind neck. It's a historical reference. If you just type in Jenny Lind and hit image, can you hear me? I think you can. And I said, I think you can. I think that position is okay. Let me go ahead and do some try to do some freehand grid. First line's in red. I have a ruler here, but here's, in fact, sometimes when I teach portraiture, one of the things I say is, listen, if you can't, if you can't draw straight lines, how on earth do you think you're ever going to do a portrait? So that's sort of what I'm telling myself right now. But if you can't draw a grid, so some of you, talk to myself, some of you aspiring portrait painters, before you do anything else, you just need to see if you can draw a grid. And I think most people can do a fairly decent job if they try, better than you would think. Okay, at this point, I have now a distance. That right there, that means this line is supposed to go right here. And I don't know if you've heard me say this before, I'm originally right-handed, but for some strange reason, did I say that right? My left hand does vertical lines better than my right hand. Yeah. I would love it to be locked. Oh, good, blocking it. Excellent. Thank you. Good idea. Thank you. Touched my screen there. So again, I'm eyeballing, I'm trying to estimate this dimension. So this is sort of a, I don't know what the word is, it's a poor man's grid, but it's actually the opposite. It's actually a difficult grid because I'm not using the ruler. Now, at this point in the grid, see, I need to start lengthening. Boy, I learned that lesson the hard way. In other words, I don't want these figures realistic. I want them elongated. I'm just estimating right here how much longer these squares should be down here. And again, I'm doing this not so that it will look like ridiculously exaggerated. No, I want it to look like it's believable. Noble dimensions. Can I use that word? Idealistic, sure. Yep, let's do one more. One more red line. I don't alter the vertical lines. They all stay the same distance apart. But the horizontal lines, the closer we get to the floor, the longer they get. So he should be 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Uh-oh. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ha! So that didn't work out right. Let me do those again and not exaggerate quite so much this time. So we'll see. That is more, I do the bottom part of their anatomy, I do more intuitively than the top part. It's up here where I need to be somewhat scientifically accurate. And I'm going to go ahead. Already the grid has helped me a little bit already, because I now find that their arms are in fact too high. So I'm going to lower. Just a little bit, not that much. reason I don't have any sound on is because the music is positively deafening. It's good, but it's deafening. So there's no music tonight. No sound, I mean. Okay, hi. Thank you.
picture of you with next to it?
Certainly. But I'm going to keep painting while you shoot. Because I ain't done yet. And I'm under the gun. Thank you. Hey, gang, can you hear me? So I've got several batteries. I think this might be the longest marathon I've ever done, nonstop video. So I know people have been coming and going, mostly going. I don't know if anybody's watching right now, are they? Yeah, a few of you. Way to go. Anyway, so the music was great, the band was awesome, but absolutely deafening. I hate to think how much hearing loss happened tonight. You only start thinking about those things when you get too old and you already have hearing loss. Anyway, I had earplugs in the entire time and it was still deafening. Anyway, it was a good night, and I like these receptions that go till midnight because, look, I almost finished a painting. I used to finish all my wedding reception paintings. But I think that was in the days before I started doing this. So I think I'm fairly happy. I'm going to look at it again tomorrow with fresh eyes. Probably deliver the painting to the couple who lives in Raleigh. So we're all going back the same way, so that should be easy. And thanks to those of you who hung in there for a while. My ears are ringing. Even with earplugs, my ears are ringing. Well, my ears ring all the time anyway, frankly, because of hearing loss, because of listening to too much loud music, and I wasn't even a rocker. Anyway. I'm kind of liking these people being really abstract, a little bit more abstract than normal, actually. And I'm thinking I like that. Now, I just realized one thing I don't have going in here is some white shirts on the men. Pretty standard. That's a trick I do a lot. Do a V shape for a shirt and then drag a brush down the middle of it for a tie. Yep. Works pretty well. Any chats I missed? Okay, some funny chats here I should look at. You guys being funny. Let me look at these before I go. whoops. Come on. There we go. Thank you, Uncle 57. A few comments. Thank you, Marlene. Do not paint the mother-in-law to get paint well. Thank you, Diego.